HTML and CSS are the true blue fundamentals for any web developer. You've learned them, and now you're feeling confident. But now what? Well, that's what I'm here to help you figure out. Let's go. In my last video, I kind of skipped over HTML and CSS. My bad. But I was so excited about giving a general overview of how to get a job in web development without any experience that I forgot to start from the very, very beginning. HTML and CSS. I mean, if you don't know what that is, I'll put some links below. But a nice analogy is a good way to start off. So if HTML and CSS were a house, HTML would probably be the foundation and the walls, where CSS would probably be the paint and all the decorations. But now you've already built a sturdy, beautiful house. What can you do with that? If you need a job right now, or you just want to build your resume, I would think about building personal websites for people, building email templates for companies, or trying your hand out at Wix or WordPress and building websites for small businesses with those tools. And lastly, becoming a webmaster for a small business. All of these jobs will gain you experience in the world of web development. I mean, not everybody knows HTML. They don't know how to go inside of a website and change an H1 to a H2. They don't know how to take a div and change it from red to blue, let alone know what a div is. So don't undersell your skills. If you do want to go into the world of web development, I don't think at this point you would be considered a web developer. If you want to become a web designer, a front-end developer, back-end developer, or DevOps, the next step is learning JavaScript. You gotta learn it, kids. I mean, if we keep up with the analogy that we were talking about earlier, JavaScript is like electricity. You flip this switch on, the lights turn on. You turn this knob, and now you have heat. It's what makes websites interactive. And once you learn it, now you can officially call yourself a web developer. And companies will start finding you appealing, and the salary is gonna start getting nice. Yeah, baby. Well, now it's time for some decision making. Are you gonna go for a webmaster job, or are you gonna wait a little bit longer and learn some JavaScript? The ball's in your court, but I'm always on your team, and if you have any more questions, leave some comments below. Also, if you found this video helpful, give it a thumbs up and share on your social media. And don't forget to subscribe. All right. Thanks for watching. Bye.